So let we shall start. Good evening to all of you. Hari Om. Om Namah Shivaya Gurave. Sachidanandamurtaye Nisprapanchaya Santaya Niralambaya Tejase. Om Gongarubhyo Namaha. Om Ganganapataye Namaha. Om Ayem Sarasataye Namaha. Om Klinkalikaye Namaha. Om Dum Durgaye Namaha. Om Rim Namah Sivaya. Om Dum Durgaye Namaha. 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 Om Durga Durga Desamani Durga Padini Varini Durga Machedini Durga Sadini Durga Nasini Durga Tudharini Durga Nihantri Durga Mapaha Durga Magyananda Durga Daitya Loka Davanala Durga Ma Durga Ma Loka Durga Matma Swarupini Durga Marga Prada Durga Ma Vidya Durga Ma Srita Durga Magyana Sansthana Durga Madhyana Bhasini Durga Moha Durga Maga Durga Martha Swarupini Durga Masura Sahantri Durga Mayudha Dharini Durga Mangi Durga Mata Durga Mya Durga Meswari Durga Bhima Durga Bhama Durga Bhadurga Dharini Om Namah Shivaya Om Namah Shivaya Om Namah Shivaya Sivoham 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 Soham 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 Japakaram Sadaguru Deva Ka Dhyana Dharam Soham 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 Japakaram Sadaguru Deva Ka Dhyana Dharam Sivoham 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 Jap karo Sadguru Deva ka dhyan dharam Soham Soham Sivoham 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 Om 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 Ram 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 Ram. So, for these prayers today, we are going to start the Gupta Sadhana, the secrets of Tantric Sadhana. Before I'm going to topics, it is very important to know once again who can actually qualify to study the science of Tantra or the Tantra Sadhana from a guru. It is very simple to understand what kind of qualification we need. We do many kind of sadhanas, but sometimes we must ask ourselves, do I trust this technique? Do I trust my guru where I got those sadhanas? Or whatever I've been studied, different schools, different masters, different teachers. Is it actually helpful to us or helpful to me? So these are the questions you may ask yourself. Sometimes you may ask, I have been studying many techniques. And I have been also practice. Tantra sadhanas or yoga sadhanas, many kind of sadhanas. Is it I'm really trusting this technique? Is it I'm trusting myself? Is it I'm trusting the guru or the masters? Or I've been studying everything because I was very much doubts, loneliness, bored, or I don't know what to do. Therefore, I study. So these are questions you may ask yourself. It is kind of self-inquiry. Sometimes we study many techniques. And we study also many scriptures. And sometimes we spend our time. From morning to evening, that means from starting our beginning of the life until the end of the life. Sometimes we think we are young enough. Like I left age of 18, the home completely. And my guru, he left his home age of 5. Adiguru Sankaracharya, he left his home age of 5 as well. And he left his body age of 32. And my guru still is alive. Sometimes we think we have a young time. We can study many things, right? We can travel one place to another. But we must ask ourselves, is it, I am young, is fine. Should I study to choose the right master to study? Or out of curiosity, like hippie style, and moving one place to another to study? So, of course, it's an individual's. They have their consciousness, they have to decide. But most of the time, actually, we don't know what we are doing. We don't know what we are studying. We don't know what kind of sadhana we are doing. We do. So then question mark comes here. Many things, many questions. Today, I was meditating. I was thinking a lot. Many things. I was thinking about myself as well, but same time I was thinking how the people are walking the path of spirituality or path of religions or path of tantra or yoga, whatever, or path of sadhanas. Most of the time, we reach such masters and teachers. They themselves have no trust to the traditions, to the lineage, to the parampara. That means such a people, there is no proper trust to the unknown. So many yoga teachers teaching also. Check them. They walk in the path of unknown? Answer is not. They walk in the path of with limited consciousness. Right? So path of spirituality is something different. Something, a personal life with the traditions, with the parampara, with the thesis. Like Adiguru Sankaracharya. It is the path of Vedanta, path of Advaita. Path of Advaita. So what I mean here, we have to actually to clarify ourselves how I can study the secrets of Tantra and what are the qualifications qualifications are very simple. Now I'm going to reveal that. You see, a great example, Milarepa, a great yogi in Tibet, we call mystic yogi in Tibet. Milarepa was very young, and during his young time, very young, means maybe 10, 12 years old, he lost his father, he lost his family, brother, sisters, whatever, I don't know, brother, sisters, not. But he left, he actually lost his father due to certain kind of quarrel, and due to village people, due to fighting, they killed his father. He lost. And he was alive with his mother. Then what happened one day? The Milarepa was suffering because due to lost his father, mother as well. Then mother was very angry how to take care of his son due to family problems, due to village and so on. So finally, out of anger or out of revenge, the mother said to Milarepa, you must go to such a guru to study the mystic science and take the revenge. Then Milarepa went to the guru, chosen by her mother. So in an ancient time, what happens, the parents are choosing the guru for their own children. But ancient time, normally what happens, we are actually guided by our parents. But today, neither we guided ourselves by parents, and our children also not listening to us as their parents, right? That is your modern education, and especially European education. All civilized countries, neither they listen to their parents and nor their children listen to them. So there are no family values today. We lost the tradition of trust. We lost the tradition of respect. We lost the tradition of mutual understandings. We lost the tradition of love, the compassion, the truth. We lost the tradition of kindness. But you see, the life of Milarepa today, we have to get this example. We must learn something through this example. So what happened? Mother sent to Milarepa. Milarepa went to Guru. And when Milarepa went to his guru, and this guru is the master of mystic science, master of tantric science. And they have such kind of black magic, revenge, many things they can do. So what happened one day? Milarepa guru said to Milarepa, you commit to study the science of Tantra and you commit to science of mystic science to get revenge. Agree? Okay, I can give that knowledge, fine. Let you qualify. So what are the qualifications? Actually, I need a special house to build. If you can build the proper house, if I'm happy, if I'm content, then actually I can deliver the science of mystic to you. I can teach. So Milarepa was agreed because mother sent to Milarepa. Then guru of Milarepa gave the all instructions how to build the house. Then Milarepa start to build in the house. Then Milarepa informed time to time, yes, the house is built, is completed. Please come and look after it. As per your guidelines or designing, I make the house. I made the house. Then most of the time, the guru came to visit. What are built by the Milarepa? So what happening most of the time, not mostly, every time, the guru of Milarepa destroying the every house. So Milarepa built the house, the guru come and destroys, is not correct. Is not correct. So it goes on, it carries on edges. It goes some years, so many years. How many years, I don't know, but some years. Then what happened? So guru all the time, they destroyed the house, destroyed the house, destroyed the house. So end of the day, after certain years, after some years, certain years, still Milarepa was young. Then guru said, guru was very happy. He destroyed the house and he was very happy. Guru also destroyed the house built by the Milarepa. So that time, the guru of Milarepa, he said, now no need to build the anymore, no need to build the more house, no need. But I am going to teach you the science of mystic science. You see, Guruji, you need the house, you need the building. But now again, you have destroyed this. But without completion of the house, how can I going to teach? Guru giving answers to Milarepa. Look, it is your karma yoga. It is your seva. So what I learned from, what you learned, I myself as a teacher. So you trust me. You carry on your duty, the seva. And you don't expect the results of the seva, the karma yoga. So what happening? You did all seva. You do your karma as I instructed. Then Milarepa asked Guruji, the house not completed, but how can you teach me? He said, actually, out of seva, out of karma, your guru need nothing. Guru actually, the aim, guru don't want anything from you as a disciple. But you must perform the seva and the karma yoga and samadhana for you can purify chitta. Establish the trust. Be surrendered to guru. Be content. Whatever guru give the instructions and wait, patience, tolerance. These the qualities are you have already developed. You have tolerance. You trusted. He surrendered to me. And you have no expectations of results of your buildings. And you never disappointed. You never frustrated. And whatever techniques I give in to build this, whatever I give in the designs to build the house, you have no doubts. You have belief in me. So these are the skills. Being a student of Tantra. So most of the time, we think, we do seva, we do karma yoga, benefit for the guru's missions. And sometimes we think I'm doing so many hours in ashram, it's benefit of the guru. So there are guru, no need so many workers to put and do the things. Sometimes people come to me, Swamiji, we are cleaning the houses, I think, we are here, therefore you don't put the workers to clean your house, clean the ashrams. That means whatever they do save, I'm expecting that work from them. So if you go authentically, guru actually need nothing from a disciple out of their seva. The idea of the guru to give the instruction to disciple to seva and karma yoga is only the purification of the chittas. No expectations, result of their actions. And need to be trusted, to surrender, and to have tolerance and wait. So these are and humbleness, whatever Guru say, and the disciples say, yes, Guruji, and I'm going to do this seva and karma. So the disciple also develop the skills of her humbleness. So these are the all are the qualities, the skills being a student of a tantric sadhaka. And after that, what happened? So Milarepa got all kind of mystic science from his guru. Because this is the purification of chitta. Purification of chitta. So after that, what happened? The Milarepa, of course, got the all kind of supernatural powers. And he took also revenge, the people who killed his father and his family's member, other members as well. The end of the day, what happened? The Milarepa also was unhappy after some time. So you can see this also movies a little bit, eh? Tibetan movies. So after what happened, Milarepa was also unhappy why he took revenge. Many people lost their lives as well. He burned the whole village and as well with the supernatural powers. And nobody can do anything with Milarepa because Milarepa have the supernatural powers. Nobody can hurt him, but he hurted himself. He was very unhappy. He was very sad. He went to depressed after some time. So Milarepa again went to his guru. Asked his guru, Guru, I got the all knowledge. I took the revenge, but I'm not very happy by taking the revenge. So what shall be done more further knowledge? Guru said, fine. Actually, I don't have the further knowledge. I got this knowledge from the guru from India. So let, if you want to go to further knowledge, let we shall go together. So guru of Milarepa and Milarepa themselves, they both all the way travel from Tibet to the end to get the higher knowledge. How to getting out of this kind of a hatred? How to get out of the hatred? Because when you hate someone, when you take revenge someone, you are hurting yourself as well. You are hurting as well. So after that, what happened after some time? Then the guru of Milarepa and Milarepa as well. So they went to guru and guru taught them the higher enlightenment, the science. The story so far goes, I think the Milarepa have the already good experience than the gurus. So Milarepa received the higher enlightenments. So after some time, what happened? The Milarepa carry the knowledge of his guru of the enlightenment and mystic science until today. And that tradition also keep going on in Tibet. So that is called, today we call Naropa traditions. That is called Naropa traditions. And I made such a guru. The incarnations. Milarepa is the incarnation of the light as enlightenment yogi, as a mystic yogi as well. So that is the one part of the being a qualified as a tantric sadhana. Am I clear that today a little bit for you, all of you? Everyone clear now? So therefore you sometimes think,
yes,
you're doing karma yoga for your guru. Actually, you are not doing karma yoga for a guru, seva doing for nothing. It is only you need to be done for your own purification of the chief. So it is clear to me as well. So then, you have to find out, is it I'm really and fit for to practice tantric science. But anyway, today, again, we are going to study Vigyan Bharata Tantra as well. We'll keep continue. So I just speak about, through the example of Milarepa, how we can study the secret science of tantras. And there is no proper sutras to what to study. But that was secret as well. So Milarepa got all knowledge of science of mystic from his guru as a secret science. And it was only a transformations between his guru and Milarepa. So I don't know what kind of knowledge Milarepa got from his guru, the mystic science. And if available in future, I can teach you, but today not available for but only I study the stories, and you can find the stories and movies as well. So today we are going to study the sutra number 4. We study yesterday, I think, sutra number 3. So sutra number 4, Vigyanabhara Tantra. Vigyanabhara Tantra. Say, Nada Bindu Mayam Vapi Kim Chandra Dhanirodhika Chakraruda Manasakam Vakim Vasakti Swarupam. He said, Nada Bindu Mayam Vapi Kim Chandra Dhanirodhika Chakraruda Manasakam Vakim Vasakti Swarupakam. Sakti Swarupakam. Nada Bindu Mayam Vapi. See, it is a nada and bindu, or can it be known by concentrating on the ascending psychic centers or the onstruct sound which emanates without any vibration? Or is it the form of the obstructing half moon, or else is it the form of Sakti? Nada Bindu Mayam Vapi Kim Chandra Ardhani Rodhikaha Chandra Rudha Manaschakam Va Kim Va Sakti Swarupakam. It is a Nada and a Bindu. So Nada means sound. Or can it be known by concentrating on the ascending psychic centers or the obstruct sound which emanates without any vibrations? Or is it form of the obstructing half moon? Or else is it the form of Sakti? So they try to ask him, actually, what is Sakti? What is actual energy? So they are talking about Sakti. Sakti Swarupakam. So is Nada, or the primary sound, is the first evolved to emerge from the Spandan or the vibration. That's what we've been studying yesterday. About Nada, the cosmic sounds, or Akshar Brahma comes. So like this, the same chapter, they continue. Say, Nada, the primary sound, is the first evolved to emerge from the Spandan, or the vibration, of that supreme consciousness. Bindu is the nucleus from which this vibration emerges. The six main chakras, or the psychic centers along the path of Kundalini, in the spinal column are Muladhara, Swadhisthana, Manipura, Anahata, Visuddhi and Ajna. But there are many more minor centers which are not as well known. The Muladhara are said to be two chakras known as Vishnu and Adhasahasra. And above Ajna, in the skull, there are nine centers known as Bindu, Adharendu, or Ardhachandrika, Nirodhika, Nada, Mahananda, or Nadanta, Shakti, Vyapika, Samani, and Unmani. Very interesting. But you can research it. It is a part of study intellectually now. But it's a lot of homework has to be done. Not only for you, also for me. So let's get the information as well. So Bindu is the point where the descending consciousness bids goodbye to the experience of unity and steps down into experience of multiplicity and diversity. It is also the point where the nectar or the amrita is held before it drips down to irrigate the entire body. Thus, it is known as the Bindu Visarga. So, Bindu Visarga already know the backside of the head, which literally means falling of the drop. On the account of this, the system of Tantra regards Bindu as an extremely important point for the experience of the transcendent. And that you can study also a little bit about Bindu, how to preserve in the Kundalini science. Then Ardhachandrika means half moon is the psyche centers which corresponds so closely with Bindu that they are often referred to as the same centers. The symbol of Bindu is also depicted as a crescent moon. Nirodhika is the psychic center where the experience of form is abstracted. Nada is center where a cosmic sound manifests, and Nadanta is the center where the difference between the sounds and the experience dissolves, or the end of sound. Sakti is the center where intense waves of bliss permeate the entire being. Vyapika is the center or abode of Sunya, which can be pierced or the transcendent only by the appearance of a jyotsna or light. Samadhi is the center where sampragyan samadhi is experienced, which is samadhi is illumination or the pratyabhijna consciousness. Unmani, you already know, unmani is the center beyond mind and thought, where the gaze is completely thrown inwards. Unmani mudra with the half closed eyes, that help you concentration. Patanjali has described the various state of sampragyan samadhi. Sampragyan, sampragya, sam means harmony. Pragya means wisdom, and which can be correlated with these higher centers, nirbitarka and nirodhika, nirvichara and adanta, ananda and sakti, asmita and samadhi. So these are the related to the Patanjali Yoga Sutra about to the samadhi. When you say nirvitarka and nirodhika, nirvichara, no vichara, no thoughts, nadanta, no sounds, ananda, the bliss, sakti, asmita. Asmita here actually means to experience the pure consciousness and samadhi. Chakra Arodhama, related to the great ascent of Kundalini, and it is pierces through the six major psychic centers, psychic energy centers, on its joining from Muladhara Chakra, at the base of the spine to Sahasra Chakra at the top of the skull. Anahata Chakra or the heart center is the seat of the construct sound and ananda, Anahata Nada, where it resounds without any objective scotch and without any interruptions. From the Anahata Nada originate all the akshara or the letters of the alphabet, which are formed by the varying frequencies of the vibration produced by this nada. This vibration produces dvani or the sound as well as jyotsna or light. Devi is curious to know if that supreme reality is any of these states awareness. So here one way, so goddess, the Devi, in this, when she asking so many questions, it means it's a part of knowledge. Like yesterday we studied. So whatever Devi asks, so we can take as a part of knowledge. But she thinking it is a Devi is curious to know if that supreme reality is any of these state of awareness. Am I clear that? If the Kundalini awakening reaches to the Sahasra, if a Nirvichara Samadhi or the Savichara Samadhi or Nadanta means so many things. She tried to explain here. So, like the, that is what they try to speak. You say, above Ajnan, in the skull, there are nine centers known as Bindu, Ardhenu, or Ardhachandrika, Nirodhika, Nada, Mahanada, or Nada, Mahanada means great Nada, great sound, Nadanta, Nadanta, the end of the sounds, Sakti, Vyapika, Samani, and Urmi. Is it through this technique, is it really one can reach the higher consciousness, the supreme consciousness, or we can reach the reality? So of course, you have to do a little bit of homework to study this. Homework. So these are the questions to the Lord Shiva and to the Vair of consciousness. So Devi is curious to know if that supreme reality is any of these states of the awareness. These are the questions. So when you go to study further and further, then you are going to understand actually and what the real answers. This is transcendent or the immanent. Say, this is Sutta number 5. Say, para paraya, para paraya ha sakalam, aparaya sa va punaha, paraya edi tadvasyata, parastam tadvi rudhyate. Is say, para paraya, para parayaha sakalam aparayasya aparayayasya vapunaha paraya yadi tadvasyat parastam tadvirudhyate. They say para parayaha transcendent cum immanent sakalam complete aparayas aparay aparayasya, they say transcendental. Yadya vapunaha यदि if वा और पुनः again पराया transcendental यदि if तद्वस्यात be like that परात्मम transcendence तत् that विरुद्धात contradicted translation what they say is your reality the transcendental immanent or it is a complete immanent or a complete transcendental if it is immanent then the very nature of transcendent is the contradicted so again two question comes so what is actually reality is the transcendental consciousness or the immanent complete immanent para parayam sakalam is the transcendent come the immanent so then we shall go through the commented Devi next inquiries about the nature of reality the immanent reality is the perceived as form and the transcendent reality is the beyond form so very interesting immanent reality the perceived as a form the transcendental reality is beyond form so that the two kind of reality either the immanent reality is a perceived as form or the beyond transcendental consciousness or beyond the form this is related to the age old question in the quest for truth whether the reality is with form or without sakara and nirakara so that is two kind of things they say what are the reality actually sakara or the nirakara sakara means the form of god nirakara means formless of god is both are the reality or it is both sakara and nirakara so what is actually the reality is sakara is reality or nirakara sakara means the form of god a form of the consciousness or nirakara formless or both then different philosophers and religions have developed theories to resolve this question however the tantric approach is more experiential it does not give much importance to the speculation but advocates a sincere efforts to the experience the reality for oneself oneself in fact at the very outset Devi has expressed or apprehensions in calling that ultimate reality immanent because in transcendence there is no room for immanence at all so when you transcend something you leave it behind that reality the ultimate transcendence which has left behind all the familiar associations of nature name form and idea along with the sensory perceptions of sight sound smell taste and touch which connect us with the external world or the immanent reality so when you transcend something you leave it behind that reality the ultimate transcendent which has left behind all the familiar associations of name form and ideas along with the sensory perceptions of sight sound smell taste and touch which connect us with the external world or the immanent reality so it's very interesting that so the two things they speak either transcend all the forms is a reality or the form is reality but actually what happened as a you are a good sadhak as a tantric sadhak we must be clear any kind of form because without form actually what you can transcend for example if I not exist this planet if a jivatma not exist nothing will be exist at all there is no god there is no atman there is no brahman because you exist right because due to your jivatma you exist atma will be there the brahman will be there the world will be there the sansara will be there the ego will be there everything will be there you are here therefore you are father mother brother sister the guru or a god whatever if you are not here in this planet there will be nothing for you right there nothing for you similarly so the form the sakar sakar meditations or sakar form is also part of reality as well so when you transcend the like jivatma we are the jivatma right we are the form we have the atma we have the brahman the reality but when you transcend this jivatma into transcendental consciousness this jivatma is called gross the external world the material world so we need to transcend this consciousness to the higher to the nirakar So in my understanding, as per scripture say so, it is all our experience level. It's all our experience. So according to my personal understandings, yes, both have the important factor in order to attain the final reality. Because whatever the form the sakara you need, in order to develop the concentration mind and transcend the sakara into nirakara, then realize the final truth. The final brahmanya, ratmanya, or final consciousness of love and compassion. The final. So need to transcend. So both are important. Both are important. Both are the part of reality. For example, we say our body and mind, we are jivatma. How can we say that we are not part of reality, right? We are the, when I say that, you have to realize this Atman within yourself as well. With this framework of this body, mind, and our the senses organs. So you need the five sense of action, five sense of knowledge, five sense of prana, the pranas, five pranas, manabuddhi, chitta, ahankar, pancha tattva, the earth, the water, the air, the fire, and the elements of the sky elements. So we need all these. We need all. So this is called sakara, the form of jivatma. This is also part of reality. Most of the time we ignore. And without this reality, how can you experience the transcendental reality? How can you experience the Atman? The consciousness of absolute within yourself. How to experience this? So in my understanding, both have the reality. Both are the reality. Sakara and nirakara as well. So you have to understand in this concept. Right? You understand now? So anyway, so according to scripture, they say that the science of Tantra one has to study or to know the reality by experiential level only, not by speculations. Even Sakar and Nirakar is not about speculations. Let you must experience, apply yourself. Then number six, they say indivisible, indivisible and indefinable. Nahi varna vibhedena, dihavedena vabhaved, paratam niskalatvena, sakalatvena tadbhaved. Nahi varna vibhedena, dihavedena vabhaved. Parastam niskalatvena sakalatvena tadbhaven. Say nahi, indivisible and indefinable. Say nahi means yet they say not, varna means color. So let me go to direct translation. Vibhedena, divisions. Dehavedana, division of forms. Va or bhavet, exist. Paratma, transcendent. Transcendence, niskala, tvina, indivisibility, sakalatvi, composite parts, no, not, tat, that, bhavet to be. Translation is a paratva or transcendent cannot exist in the divisions of varna. Very interesting. Paratva or the transcendental consciousness cannot divide. Cannot separate. Nahi varna vibhedena dehavedena bhavet, paratvam niskalatvena sakalatvena tadbhavet. Not possible. The transcendental consciousness cannot exist in the division of varna, or the color, shabda, the sound, or the rupa, the form. If transcendence is indivisible, then it cannot be defined or coexist with the composite parts. So anyway, the transcendental consciousness cannot be divide, cannot be separate, cannot disconnect, disconnect, cannot be disconnect, cannot be separate. So cannot be color, cannot be sabda, cannot be rupa. Rupa means form, sabda the sound. It is a transcendental consciousness. If transcendental consciousness is indivisible, indivisible, not visible, indivisible, then it cannot be defined or coexist with the composite parts. It's not possible. So it means here, as per my understanding, the transcendental consciousness is the reality. The transcendental consciousness is the reality. The reality is not possible to substitute anything. It's not possible to separate. It's not possible to dissect. It's not possible to dilate. The transcendental consciousness, is not possible to dilute. And something, it was, it is, it will be, eternally exist, is the truth. That is the Brahmagyan. And that is the love. Love means something. It was, it is, and it will be. It will be. So that we need to experience. The love, the transcendental consciousness, we need to experience with ourself, within the, without self, in the samadhi, and you have to experience that love with all beings as well. Then your life of suffering is over. The life of misery is over because you experience that love with all beings. That not possible anyone can make you unhappy. Not possible. Nobody can make frustrated. So enlightenment person, atmagyani person, actually see the love within all beings. Even if, even that love one can see in your enemy as well, and within the enemy as well. Even the satru, he can also see that. This immanent reality or the finite world is made up of sabda, varna, and rupa, are the sound, color and form. So the immanent reality, the finite world, the samsara, is made by the sabda, varna, rupa, sound, color, and form. We know this experience very well, as we have ample of experience of it in our daily life. It is a transcendent reality that we are unfamiliar with. Here, so what happened? The samsara we can see every day, but the transcendental consciousness, we did not experience, and we can't see exactly what it is. So therefore, unfamiliar. And here, it has been described as indivisible, undefinable, and unmanifest. So that is the transcendental consciousness, and it is the reality. Therefore, these three aspects of sound, color, and form, which together shape our perceptions of the manifest or the finite world, have no existence or role to play the transcendent. That is how it is. Again, very interesting that. So here it has been described as indivisible. So indivisible, undefinable, and unmanifest. Therefore, these three aspects of sound, color, and form, which together shape our perceptions of the manifest or finite world, have no existence or role to play in transcendent. So what they try to speak, whatever we are experiencing, whatever you are experiencing, it has no role in the transcendental consciousness. It means that the samsara is not the final reality, the supreme consciousness. The samsara, so where we are actually experiencing every day, the life of stress and strain, the life of suffering and misery. So this is not reality. The reality means when we are experiencing reality, because it is a reality, is the transcendental consciousness. What does that mean? So through transcendental consciousness, we can experience that the reality, that love, that compassion, that truth. And that consciousness, that means the consciousness of Atma, the conscious love, the compassion, and that the supreme truth is going to help you in your daily life, and you can manage the whole kind of difficulties you have in your daily lives. But that what you are experiencing in daily life, what you are experiencing, we experience therefore these three aspects, sound, color, and form. That is what we are experiencing every day. The sounds is there, everything is color or the form. Is whatever exists in the samsara, is everything is a form. The trees, the animals, the father, the mother, so whatever you're giving the names. So when you are identified by any names, so this is the form. This is the form. And colors, it has, we have, I would say Indradhanu, how many colors, right? Seven colors. So how many colors? Seven or nine? The rainbow, how many colors? Yogananda.
Undefinable. Many, undefinable colors.
Actually, rainbow, we can see some colors, but there is many colors. But according to science, I think there are seven colors, right? Atmanan,
yeah.
As per science.
Six colors, and then white and black.
But white is also colored because it is manifested in white.
It's six colors and white.
Seven. So whatever is given the name is always color. Then after that, say sound. So whatever we speak, the sounds are there, the colors are there, the names are there. So three things are available, but in the finite world, in the samsara. So finite world means samsara. So I have no existence or role to play in transcendental consciousness. You see, they say these are no roles at all to play in the transcendental consciousness, but it is a medium to. So we must take the help of the sound, color, and form so that we can take a medium in order to attain the transcendental consciousness. Although they say that, but once you reach the transcendental consciousness, but there is no, because you have to leave them. You have to leave. You leave the sound, leave the color, leave the form. Then you can experience that the transcendental consciousness. So here many things, many question comes. So the question come form, color, and sound. So that we are going to also to study in the further sutras and see that. So we'll check that, how it goes on. When you say form, like mantras, mantra also the form, Akshara Brahma, it is a form. The Om is a form. The sounds, Sunchani mantras, these are the sounds. Sounds are many sounds. Like bells, ringing, many things. And then what happening? Then the burn of the colors and color manifest as well. So three things are there. So we have to take them. Like you study all scriptures, it is a form. You study mantra yoga, it is a form. You study chakra yoga, the kundalini yoga, and meditation chakra is the form. So these are not the, but it helps you to reach the transcendental consciousness. It helps you. Am I clear that? The sound, the color, so these are the essential and as a medium in order to attain that the supreme consciousness or the transcendental consciousness. But again, here Devi, so you have to be very clear. Still Devi have the doubts. You get me? So these are the questions. Is it the sound and the colors and the form and has no roles in the transcendental consciousness? And that you have to be clear. Like we sometimes meditate, we experience many colors, right? We listen to many sounds, right? And we can see any forms, we can visualize light, colors, and forms. But these are not the reality because there is no. There is no transcendental consciousness. So far, we are experiencing the lights and colors or forms, anything. So this means you are not attain the supreme consciousness or the reality. Am I clear that the color, the sound, and the form, it is not the reality. So you can check that many people meditate. Oh, I see this color, I see this light, I see this form, I see that form. I listen to these sounds. These are we are experiencing the meditation normally. So So many kind of meditation we are really experience the form. We can see many visions, many colors. Then we can visualize Shiva, Kali, Durga, and we can listen the sounds of bell or the sounds of cosmos or sound of the sounds of anything. And then colors. So we can also visualize many colors as well. So these are the that what you're experiencing in the meditations. So according to the beginning of Tantra and the colors, the forms, right? It has no roles in the translation. It means the form, the color, the sound is not reality, right? So this is how we can go to conclude. So only the transcendental consciousness, so absence of sound, absence of colors, absence of form is the supreme reality. And that is how the beginning of Tantra and the Sutra try to explain. But still, the Lord Shiva, and he's still not opening the mouth, right? So these are all our questions and asked by the Divine Mother, Mother Vairavi, Devi, the Goddess, the Consort of Lord Shiva. You can give any name. So you can give any name. So thanks for today. Thanks for today. But still, we have to go through the form. Because form, we have to take medium. Like this physical body is a form. So we have to take it with the form. Like Sanay chanting mantras, create also vibrations as well, the sounds. It does help for concentration mind. But when you reach the transcendental consciousness, you leave them all here and now. When you reach the transcendental consciousness, you have to leave the samsara. Samsara will be no there. If you then you really can experience that the final, the pure love, the complete love, the absolute love, the compassion, the higher truth. The higher truth. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vasishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Om Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om. Lokaha Samastaha Sukhino Bhavantu. Lokaha Samastaha Sukhino Bhavantu. Lokaha Samastaha Sukhino Bhavantu. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Harihi Om. Om Gurubhyo Namaha. So today the day 5th. So may Mother Durga bless you, all of you. Bless all of you. Let you must receive the grace of Parasakti in order of awakening this Kundalini and reach the transcendental consciousness. So that we all are can free from the miseries, the karmas, then enter into kingdom of the Paravidyas, the supreme consciousness. Thank you. Aparavidya, para, apara, the supreme consciousness.